Good morning, my students. Our today's topic is Neza. Neza is a medicine prepared from snake venom. The name of the snake is Indian cobra. Hooded snake. Flanks is wide open and hooded. You may also call Neza as a medicine a blood relative of lachesis. Those who are a snake lover, they call cobra, Indian cobra, a charming snake. One of our great pioneer, P.C. Majumdar, told, the poison of the deadly cobra has been efficient from ancient times. In homeopathy, it was introduced by Russell and Stoke, who made the first proving, and with some 40 provers. But it is rather remarkable that so many able provers, Neza should not have attained anything approaching the place of importance that occupied by lachesis. Nash opined that this may be due to the fact that many of the proving of lachesis are made with 30th potency, while those of Neza was with low potency. Now I am sharing the exact experience what Russell got during proving. We all know the substance which having capacity to produce some symptoms, if anyone having suffering from those symptoms, that will cure. That is the disease producing power of any substance is the disease curing power. In that perspective, just I do like to share the experience of Russell, the introducer of Neza in homeopathic field, what he experienced. It was in the year 1853, 31st January, at early morning at about 6 a.m., he took little water with first titration of Neza. And he wrote, just after taking the dose, he felt some uneasiness in stomach, but soon passing off. While dosing was roused by sudden sense of choking in throat, a sort of grasping. A few minutes later, felt sudden jerking in left masseter. In about 3 to 4 hours, had unusual beating of heart that is audible to himself, that is fluttering of heart. So, the active principle of Indian cobra is alpha cobra toxin. It is neurotoxic in nature. So, the sphere of action is in on brain mostly, in cerebellum, in medulla, in all nerves. Apart from that, it also acts on heart, valves, respiration, throat, and also in general sepsis. Now I am also sharing another experience of Frank Buckland. How did he experience the action of these venom on brain? He wrote, quote, I had not worked 100 years before all of a sudden I felt just as if somebody had come behind me and struck me a severe blow on the head and neck. And at the same time, I experienced most acute pain in my chest, oppression in my chest, as if a hot iron had been drawn in and 100 weight put on the top of it. The hot iron symptom, weight on the chest, should be specially noted. Once again, I am quoting Dr. Majumdar. He wrote, a young woman suffering from a heart affection had operation in chest among almost to suffocation. Feeble, irregular, almost imperceptible pulse, anemic appearance, inability to speak. One dose of Neza was given and acted beautifully. NASA has been found in very decided use of affection of the heart, especially weak heart of diphtheria, where there is impending heart failure or paralysis. Its action settles around the heart, hypertrophy of the heart, valvular disease of the heart. Another important thing is marked surging of blood upwards. Surging of blood upwards with marked dyspnea, inability to lie on left side. Inability to lie on left side is a grand characteristics of NASA. Almost in all symptoms we are getting this. Another important symptom is organs seem to be drawn together. They are very susceptible to cold. With heart symptom, they are getting also pain in head, especially left side of the temple. Generally, mentally they are very sad, unhappy. The use of NASA has extended far beyond its proving. Dr. Kane said that clinically NASA is ranking high than the proving records. Now I am telling about the mental attitude, mind and disposition of NASA patient. Most of the NASA patient, generally almost all, they are very much anxious. Almost anxiety comes to agony with sad and depressed, melancholic temperament. They are anxious. They are anxious. They are having agony, but not so much excitement like aconite. Aconite also anxious, but they are very much excited. In case of NASA, they are anxious, but depressed, melancholic. Mostly anxious look we are getting. Another point is tendency to brood over imaginary troubles, especially negative thoughts, misfortunes. You will get this symptom in your Allen's keynote as a starting symptom of NASA. In brackets, you will get Aurammet. So in case of NASA, they brood over imaginary troubles, especially misfortune, negative thoughts. In case of Aurammet, they are also broodsable. But broodsable, suicidal thoughts. Another medicine we are getting in homeopathic Medica, they are also having a tendency to brood over imaginary trouble, that is Ignatia. They generally brood over grief, disappointments, etc. So, whenever we are getting any medicine, and the relatives of the patient, they are reporting like that, always he or she is broodsover, very sad and melancholic, as if always she is thinking or he is thinking something. Then we have to ask, on what topics you are brooding over? In case of NASA, it is misfortune, negative thoughts. In case of Aurammet, broods over suicidal thoughts. In case of Ignatia, broods over grief, broods over disappointment. Almost at times they feel very unhappy, and in extreme case, then they become very much sensitized with melancholy, sad and depressed mood, then suicidal insanity may develop. After long continued broods over or negative thoughts, they may develop suicidal insanity. Another important feature, it is associated with physical symptom also, chronic nervous palpitation. Palpitation especially after delivering lecture for a long time. Those are usually delivering lecture, the political leaders in old days, those who are preaching in churches or in different mountain missions, they may have suffered from palpitation after speaking. And ultimately, they could not speak, inability to speak with choking feeling and palpitation. And dragging and anxiety at pycnodic region, occurring in great grief. Also, smarting pain in back from same cause, pain in precordia and pain in back, nervousness, morbid anxiety with fear of death. When they are getting palpitation, when they are getting chest pain, they may fear, having fear of death, or dreads to be left alone. Now I am giving four symptoms of nasa, not getting in common Materia Medica, but it is in source book and also in Kent's repertory. First is delusion under superhuman control. When we discussed on Lachesis, we have already discussed on the symptom, delusion under superhuman control. It is Lachesis, a good medicine. Another medicine is Thuja. Another medicine is Anacardium. But in ranking high, in similar rank, we are getting Lachesis, Thuja and Nasa. Anacardium in third grade. Another important manifestation we are getting in Kent's repertory is irresolution, confusion, especially at awakening at morning, with sadness and melancholy. So alternating mood, sometimes we are getting happiness for a very little time, for a few minutes, then followed by unhappiness. Everything seems to her is wrong. Whatever is happening around her or around him, it seems to him it is wrong. Then physical genitals, mostly head hot but limbs are cold, less appetite, craving for stimulants which aggravate the state, great desire for wine during sickness. They are generally thirsty, and like Lachesis, they are also having same trouble, similar trouble, sensitiveness and uneasiness in external throat. If we consider thermal reaction, they are chilly, and mental and physical exertion causing violent palpitation. So if we consider the personality profile of nasa patient, first they are very anxious, second they are very depressed and melancholic, third they are having tendency to brood over imaginary troubles, especially misfortune. When all the symptoms goes together and sensitize the patient as a whole, they may develop suicidal tendency. Another points in mind and disposition, delusion under superhuman control, someone is commanding, like Lachesis, like Thuja, like Anacardium. Though another point is irresolution. The important thing for decision making, what he or she is getting trouble, as if everything seems to her is wrong. Regarding physical genitals, already I have told, the head is hot but limbs are cold, appetite is less, but craving for stimulants is aggravates, they are thirsty, and thermal radiation is chilly. Mental and physical exertion causing palpitation. Now we are going forward for particular symptom. First, head. Even if you search, just type the words NASA in Google search, you will get NASA is a homeopathic medicine and effective for migraine with the symptom what we are getting in our Materia Medica. It is so common and popular. So pain in left temple and left orbital region, spreading out occiput with nausea and vomiting. So in case of NASA, we are getting trouble like Lachesis in left side. Pain in left temple, left orbit, up to the occiput with nausea and vomiting. Even patients, those who are suffering from hay fever, that is allergic rhinitis, they may also suffer from headache. But with headache, the head is hot but extremities are cold. The head symptoms are aggravates in warm room, the head feels warm, fever, yet the feet limbs cold. Another important associated symptoms with headache, it is fluttering of heart. Fluttering. With headache, pulse, regular in rhythm, but irregular in force. Maybe feeble, maybe flu or full. The headaches are nondescript. Of a congestive character all over the head, especially occiput. Headaches accompanied by quick and nervous pulse. Awakes with headache every morning, dull, heavy constriction across forehead, heaviness of the eyes with dryness of the throat, eyes sunken and dark, and incapacity to much exertion for mass exertion, both for mind and body. Waking with dull pain in head may also be attended with fluttering of the heart. Some patient may having a sensation of weight in vertex with cold feet, but flushing of face. A neuralgic pain in head, it may be migraine or any other headache, followed by or preceded by nausea or vomiting, or left orbital region, temporal and occipital region, and increase to throbbing. Then it was drying in character to back of the head. Sometimes it may aggravate from overeating, from mental exertion, from physical exertion. Now we are going forward for another particular symptom, throat. Pressure and gagging feeling in the throat. Constriction and dryness of the throat. Grasping at throat with signs of choking and inability to talk. After catching cold, pain in throat and frequent tendency to short cough, cook, cook, short cough, quick full pulse. Flushed face, tongue is white, moist and large. Right tonsil may swollen, otherwise it is left-sided. But in throat symptom, right tonsil may swollen with sharp pain in it. Short heart cough worse at night, pain up right side of the neck, finally incessant cough. First short cough, then incessant cough. Considerable heat of the skin, faces red. Larynx tended to touch externally. With inclination tuck of cough when pressure was made there. If you press here, patient will tonsil is swollen. In case of diphtheria, just like lachesis, when larynx is invaded, patient grasps at throat with sensation of choking, forces dark red, fetid breath, offensive breath, short hoarse cough, with a raw feeling in upper part of the trachea. Diphtheria, impending paralysis of the heart, that is infective myocarditis due to effect of toxin of Cyanobacterium diphtheriae. In those cases, patient may blue, awakens from sleep gasping, pulse intermittent and thready. Now we are going for another particular symptom in genitalia female first. Nasa is a very good medicine for left ovarian trouble. It may be ovarian cyst or any other inflammatory disease. Crampy pain in left ovary with severe palpitation radiation pain to the heart. Don't forget this symptom. Whenever you are getting any female patients having pain in left ovary which radiates to the heart with severe palpitation and anxiety and fear of death with cold sweat in hand and feet, we may think of Nasa. Ovarian congestive neuralgia with violent palpitation, a thin whitish leucorrhea. So in case of female life, though it looks like particular symptom, but it generalized. Pain in left ovary radiates to the heart with fluttering palpitation, along with anxiety, along with fear of death, everything we are getting. In male genitalia, Nasa, it is beautifully written in Allen's Encyclopedia. The peculiar distress about the generative organs of males, attended with great depression of mind. otherwise they are depressed. But sexual desire, morbidly strong, yet no physical power. Sexual desire is very high, morbidly high, but no physical power. Constant violent sexual desire, but with little physical power. Thus the night was passed most miserably, frequent working, with vivid imagination, and much painful state of the mind. In selected case, we are also getting involuntary seminal emission followed by great prostration and distress. Now we are going forward for respiratory symptom. Dyspnea with sticky mucus and saliva, not too much expectoration. Asthmatic constriction falls at approach of evening. Asthma beginning with coryza. First coryza, then followed by asthma. There is much sneezing with running water from the nose, inability to lie down at night, followed by dryness of the air passage, nose, and followed by dyspnea. So in case of nasa, it starts with coryza and watering, followed by dyspnea at the evening. The patient is suffocating attacks in August. The nasa patient is subject to severe attacks of bronchitis also. There is no rawness between the larynx and trachea, which aggravates after coughing. This is a great remedy in asthma, especially if it be cardiac asthma. The breathing is so bad that he cannot lie down. The whole chest is in a state of congestion. Emptiness in the left side of the chest. Low intermittent pulse. With all the complaints of the chest, there is inability to lie on the left side. Inability to lie on the left side is a grand characteristic of nasa. It may be heart symptom, it may be angina, it may be bronchial asthma, even it may be ovarian pain associated with heart pain. Inability to lie on left side. Numbness of the left arm. There is dyspnea. If he goes to sleep, he wakes up suffocating, gasping, choking, starts from sleep as if in a dream. Now we are going forward for heart. Generally, nasa, the medicine is being used for most of the homeopaths as a common medicine for heart. So we should know detail, particular of the heart symptom of nasa as we get effectiveness of this medicine, both in acute and chronic stage. It is used in valvular troubles of the heart in young person who grow up with cardiac valvular disease. So, in earlier part, we got information about throat symptom, infection of the tonsil, followed by heart symptom. That is, nasa patient, those who are young, they may be a known case of rheumatic arthritis. First started in throat complaint, that is being suppressed by any way, now develop heart symptom with valvular complication, thickening of the valve. The whole trouble settled about the heart. This suggests nasa, and nasa has often cured. If the valvular trouble is congenital, it cannot be cured. Kent said in his Metra Medica. Keep it mind. If the valvular trouble is congenital, it cannot be cured. But if not, it shows that all the disturbing forces have settled about the heart. These cardiac cases are often attended by a dry, hacking cough, a cough with every little exertion, slightest exertion also causing cough. It is not a catarrhal state, nor is it tubercular like bronchial asthma. Whenever patient is suffering from cardiac trouble in nasa, they are getting hacking cough, but not catarrhal. There is a dry hacking cough with sweating in palms and hand, already I have told. The heart beats slowly and will not be asked to work. Cough comes on from exertion. Cactus also has a cardiac cough with constriction, but squeezing as if grafts with iron band, grafts and ungrafts in cactus. Constriction as if grasped with iron band, grasped and ungrasped. Acute pain and sense of oppression in chest as though a hot iron had been run into it, 100 weight put upon it. Cannot lie a moment on left side. Once again I am telling. In respiratory trouble, cannot lie a moment on left side. In cardiac trouble, cannot lie a moment on the left side. But great relief of pain and breathing on lying on right side in cardiac cases. There is copious sweating of the hands and feet, causing the gloves and shoes to rot out. But the sweat is not offensive. Profuse sweating on hands and feet, but not offensive. There is a sense of fullness and puffiness of the hands and feet, showing a slow circulation in the veins, which we might expect. Now we are about to conclude the modalities. First, aggravation. If we consider position, pain aggravates lying on left side. Pain aggravates lying on left side. Carriage riding. Stages, after menses and after sleep. Sleep into aggravation we are also getting in nasa, like lachesis. But in case of lachesis, after commencement of menses, she feels better. In case of nasa, they feel better after menses. Then exposure, drafts of air, cold air, wet weather, all are causing aggravation of trouble. In physical level, pressure of clothes with feeling of constriction in throat, both internally and externally. Regarding food, wine causing aggravation, though it craves. Time, especially in early morning, 5 a.m. after awakening. Amelioration, riding in open air and sneezing. Now I do like to compare with nasa with other snacks. It is important to compare the symptom of nasa with those of other snacks. The patient is distributed by closeness of the collar after sleep, both in lachesis and nasa. There are exhaustion and trembling of the muscles. Its direction is somewhat like lachesis from left to right, the ovarian pain, the diphtheria, the joint pain, etc. Nasa like lachesis aggravation in damp weather also. Nasa is more nervous. Lachesis is more septic. Nasa is more nervous. Lachesis is more septic. Nasa having marked agitation may or may not having sepsis. Lachesis, all the nervousness with a tendency to hemorrhage and sepsis. Black blood like charred straw, dark clotted. Nasa surging of the blood upwards like lachesis. It is a distressing symptom, but nasa is not a hemorrhagic drug. Then if we can consider relationship, it is antidoted by ammonia. We may compare the depression of suicidal tendency with Orammet, already we have discussed. Headache from before and backwards, anacardium, bryonia, from behind forwards, gelsemium, from left to right, then once again in left, lacanianum, sanguinaria, right, and diphtheria, in heart symptom, cactus, in collapsing condition, carbophage, camphor, tabacum. In case of nasa, in heart symptom, if there is anginal pain, in almost all cases pain will radiate upward to neck and up to temple. In case of spigelia, in anginal pain, it radiates upwards left side, but in face looks like as if he is suffering from trigeminal neuralgia. In case of nasa, those who are suffering from heart complaint, anginal pain, it appears patient is suffering from migraine, headache with nausea and vomiting. But we should inquire about the origin of the pain. So, like Lachesis, though Naga is not in that sense so broad spectrum, but it is a very good remedy, an effective remedy whenever we are using in our daily practice, both for acute and chronic stays, with typical personality profile and characteristics, particulars and modalities. Thank all of you. Stay at home. Be safe at home. Thank you.